we do have absolutely universal to economics, and to political economics is the model that there's fundamental inadequacy, fundamental scarcity. Therefore, all politics are based on the fact that there's not enough ground. Someday, a whole lot of people are going to die, and I have a theory. And my theory is the fairest, I think, and the wisest and the most economical. Therefore, you better join up with me, and your family better join up with me. That's why I have a politician. Now, realize that. Then you're going to have a showdown to see whether the other thing be big enough for you. So we join up sides, and then we're going to have the great Armageddon to see which of the great world sides are going to win, the communists or the capitalists, whatever it may be. It's not that way. Having discovered there really is enough to go around, I then find that the politics are really now obsolete. People are so used to the idea, I can have a leader. Yeah. They also had to have a leader when we were illiterate. We didn't have words. We didn't have the communication. We didn't have the information. Oh. Suddenly, everybody, once it was that the pharaoh was in on their face, and the nobles were, and the middle class. Just in this century, everybody's suddenly in on their face. Everybody's in the book out there. Everybody can communicate. So suddenly, it is really going to be everybody, and everybody going to have to know in a hurry that there really is enough to go around. Now, if there is enough to go around, and you and I know there is, you and I don't need a politician to tell us how to make sense of the city. He doesn't have to, the politician, tell you now it's your turn to speak. You and I cooperate and try to bring out the information in a logical way.
Yeah.
And society just does not do that. Anyway, we're not used to that. We're used to the idea of not going around, so we elect you, and it's up to you to be sure that our side comes out on top.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, and
that's why all the flag waving and all the guns and everything is out there. But it's just no longer, it's actually no longer so. Now this is what we're up against either a bloody revolution ahead, thinking it has to be you or me with all the bombing capability, $200 billion a year being spent to get ready for Armageddon by the leading nations of Earth. I say, we're going to have either a revolution of blood, but everybody loses them. Or it's going to be a design revolution where we do use the ephemeralization. We do more than less. We do get all of humanity successful by 1985.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very touch-and-go matter. Therefore, one of, to me, I take a very deep sense of responsibility that you and I are invited to be on the air to communicate to a number of people.
Yeah.
And boy, I say, most important thing is how to get all of humanity to find out what it is all about in the shortest possible time.
Yes.
If man does have the option to make it, he didn't know it, but now he has.
And we're at a very crucial moment now, and
that's
it's a very, very crucial, and it's a privilege to be alive, conscious, and able to participate at this particular time in the scenario of the evolution of universal consciousness. But as we say, as we refer to the old systems by which the planet has been operating, and we can have a sense of a new capability that's gleaned or able to be realized through mind's ability to perceive this, it's possible to conceive also that the great numbers of the general citizenry of the United States who perhaps might be viewing this particular program through an extended cable vision system linked through satellite capability, it might be difficult for them to realize that if their identities are, or their immediate securities are, wrapped up in the premises of the old organizing assumptions, the political structure of which they are a part, it might be that in a certain measure, that system that people have been living by must be addressed by the new conscious. The old reality, in a sense, must be dealt with I have a feeling that it would have to be dealt with in a way we can ignore the old pattern by which we've been operating, or that we bring a process by which those in them will realize that they are able to participate and are part of this as well. Because if we're having a fundamental change, and if we have a condition from a historical condition in a dialectical pattern whereby a new system wiped out the old system that had been established, then those people in positions of responsibility for the old organizing assumptions of political leadership or whatever kind of position of leadership fear the kind of change which is feeling abroad in the land, and that perhaps for the first time in the evolution of consciousness we have the opportunity by where through a process of a conscious understanding on their part of a transference from the condition of scarcity to surplus, that the fundamental change can happen in a mode where nobody loses, including those who've been responsible for the old way of doing things.
Our responsibility is to enlighten, elucidate, not ask anybody to believe, but show them why it is so, that there now can't be enough.
Mm-hmm.
To realize then that as out. But evolution, however, is a work. And you and I didn't invent that universe. We didn't invent that planet. We didn't invent those laws. There's something much bigger out there. All the thing to do is to stand off and try to see with those eyes. Now, the things that happen evolutionarily, we have politics everywhere. With the information system we have today, are becoming quite clearly highly corruptible. Especially good human beings, but thinking is not enough to go around. Then playing tricks. How do you get them? Well, you don't want to really kill the other man, but you don't want to lie. It's immoral if you do it for yourself, but it's immoral if you do it for people who love all those kind of ways of temporizing with the truth.
Yeah.
And man has been doing that.
Yeah.
So poor little man, I see the politicians are now in such a bind.
Mr. Nixon.
It's quite clear that politics are corruptible, that you can't get an office without buying it, all those things.
Yeah, more or less the way the country's
all right.
set up.
No, but then this was always true, but now it's out in the open.
Yeah,
that's why we have a young world.
Yes.
It's becoming disillusioned with the idea that how you get solid problems by politics. They're beginning to really say, how does the universe work? I see if we get to the moon and not lose a single human being on that kind of undertaking.
Right.
And I take experience. That's what we ought to be doing about how do we make our spaceship work.
Yeah.
So there's a young world coming through, and I find that absolutely will not put up with lies.
Uh-huh.
It's manifest, it's abhorrence of any misrepresentation.
Right.
Is just is most cheering of all the news we have.